What's unique about Aidan and Joe is the fact that they're missing their arm at the shoulder level. And it's a very unique and it's a difficult location of an amputation, not very common. Most upper extremity amputations are a result of trauma. It's different because you have different muscle control that we have to try to focus in on without having the anatomy of a humerus or a bicep, and those are more typical cases that we see. The most unique thing about it is the input. Traditionally, there would be one or two sensors where you would just, you know, focus on pushing one or the other in order to make the arm happen. And now there's multiple sensors that work kind of like an EMG signal, so it can read multiple muscle movements in order to create a pattern, and then the arm would recognize that that pattern equates to opening my hand or closing my hand or extending the elbow and flexing the elbow. So every time they calibrate it, they're adding in their feedback from their body activity, and that is responding to what it's getting the arm to do. The fact that there's more signals and more opportunity for surface control, it requires less brain function in terms of having to overthink of what they're doing. Historically, you can have a mental fatigue for patients that have to keep thinking about three different things in order to get one thing to happen. Now they can kind of think about one thing and it's able to happen. So that's the most unique thing about the technology.